हाय गाइस, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल। टुडे वी विल स्टडी अबाउट टाइप फोर हाइपर सेंसिटिविटी। एज वी नो दैट हाइपर सेंसिटिविटी इज एन एग्जैजरेटेड इम्यून रिस्पॉन्स बाय अ होस्ट बॉडी टू अ फॉरेन और सेल्फ एंटीजन टू विच इट हैज बीन प्रीवियसली एक्सपोज्ड। एंड दी हाइपर सेंसिटिविटी इज ऑफ फोर टाइप्स: टाइप वन हाइपर सेंसिटिविटी, टाइप टू एंड टाइप थ्री एंड टाइप फोर हाइपर सेंसिटिविटी। सो देर आर फोर टाइप्स ऑफ हाइपर सेंसिटिविटी एंड इन दिस वीडियो वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द टाइप फोर हाइपर सेंसिटिविटी। ऑल दिस टाइप वन, टाइप टू एंड टाइप थ्री हाइपर सेंसिटिविटी आर एंटीबॉडी मीडिएटेड। मीन्स डिफरेंट एंटीबॉडीज, डिफरेंट क्लास ऑफ एंटीबॉडीज लाइक IgG, IgA, IgM आर इन्वॉल्व इन दीज थ्री हाइपर सेंसिटिविटी रिएक्शंस। बट इन टाइप फोर हाइपर सेंसिटिविटी रिएक्शन इट इज मीडिएटेड बाय द टी सेल्स। These cells are known as T cells because these are produced by the thyroid gland in our body. Type 4 hypersensitivity is also known as delayed type cell mediated hypersensitivity. It is known as delayed type hypersensitivity because this hypersensitivity takes a few days to 1 or 2 weeks to develop. So that's why this is known as delayed type hypersensitivity. As I've told you earlier that T cells mediate this type 4 hypersensitivity reaction. And T cells are of two types. First is the CD4 plus cells and second is the CD8 plus cells. These CD4 plus cells are also known as TH cells or the T helper cells. And CD8 plus cells are known as killer T cells. And as the name suggests, these killer T cells just kills their target. So if any foreign or self antigen enters the body of the host, then these killer T cells will just directly attack on the antigen and will kill it. But when these CD4 plus cells attack the foreign antigen that enters the body, so if the type 4 sensitivity is mediated by these CD4 plus cells, then these CD4 plus cells, which are known as TH helper cells, and as the name suggests, these T helper cells does not kill the antigen by itself. Instead, they induce an immune response from other cells such as the macrophages or the monocytes. So this is the basic difference between the type 4 hypersensitivity, which is mediated by either the CD8 plus cell or the CD4 plus cell. Now let's look at the pathological mechanism of the type 4 hypersensitivity reaction, especially in case of CD4 plus cells, how the type 4 hypersensitivity develops. So in this case, we can take the example of contact dermatitis disease. This disease is mainly caused by the plant species such as Parthenium or poison ivy. So let's take the example of the poison ivy. So this contact dermatitis disease, which is caused by the poison ivy, can cause rashes on the skin of the host body. Poison ivy, for example, contains an allergen known as urushiol. This allergen so when a host body or a human body gets in contact with this poison ivy, then this urushiol enters the host body through the hands, through the epidermis of the hands. This urushiol enters the host body. As the foreign allergen from the poison ivy enters our epidermis, this is the epidermis of our skin. As it crosses the epidermis, it enters our skin, and this allergen is now taken up by the dendritic cells present in the cells of our body. So these dendritic cells act as the APC or the antigen presenting cells, and these dendritic cells engulf this allergen. And these allergens are engulfed by these APC or the dendritic cells and are presented to the naive T cells. Now the naive T cells produce some cytokines such as the IL-2. This IL-2 is also known as the autocratic growth factor, which helps in the proliferation of the naive T cells. Now the naive T cells mature to form TH1 cells and TH17 cells. Mostly it forms the TH1 cells. After the formation of these cells, TH1 cells and the TH17 cells, we can say that this epidermis or the skin is now sensitized, or the host body is now sensitized. So we can say that the first step of this type 4 hypersensitivity reaction, which is the sensitization phase, is now completed. Now let's look at the second phase or the effector phase. Now in this second phase of the effector phase, what happens is these TH1 cells are already sensitized. So as the antigens after these TH1 cells are sensitized, when these antigens again enters, now these TH1 cells will secrete some cytokine known as the interferon gamma. And these interferon gamma acts on the macrophages and increase the ability of macrophages to phagocytose. And more site of MHC2 molecules are produced, means more and more macrophages and monocytes are produced. And also there is increased secretion of a cytokine like IL-1 and TNF-alpha. So these factors in turn increases the number of the immune cells such as the monocytes and the neutrophils in the skin cells. So more and more neutrophils and monocytes and macrophages are produced here. And as more and more allergens enters through the epidermis, these increased quantity of the macrophages and the monocytes acts on these allergens or the antigens, and in turn they produces a lot of secretions here. And these secretions are all the enzymes which helps in killing of these antigens, these foreign antigens which enters the host body. So these lytic enzymes kill these antigens, but in the process of doing so, they damage the skin tissue cells as well. So they damage the skin tissues in places, and this in turn cause the redness and itching in the skin tissue area, which is due to all of these reactions, or we can say that this is the result of the type 4 hypersensitivity reaction. So we can say that the contact dermatitis disease, which causes this redness or itching, is caused by the type 4 hypersensitivity reaction. So this is all that is there in the type 4 hypersensitivity. If you have any doubts, you can ask them in the comment section.